Alright, so this is the page where we really get into naming. Okay, we're going to learn how to put everything together and make a full alkane name by the end of this page. So rule number three, this is after we've already identified the longest chain and the direction of that chain. Rule number three is to designate numerical locations of substituents. Okay, so what that means is that I'm going to want to actually say, okay, is this substituent on two or is it on three? Okay, now when there's more than one identical substituents. So let's say that I have two one-carbon groups. Instead of naming them both individually, we want to cluster them together to save some space and to save some time. So what we're going to do is we're going to use prefixes. These prefixes are going to tell us how many of that type of substituent we have. So the prefix for two is di. The prefix for three is tri. And the prefix for four is tetra. Okay, so di, tri, and tetra. And when we do represent these chains, these branches, they aren't true alkanes. And the reason is because they're always going to be missing an H because of the fact that they are on a branch. So for example, let me just give you an example. Here I have a long chain, and then I have a two carbon chain coming off of it. Okay, the molecular formula of this two carbon chain is CH2CH3. Okay? The molecular formula for a normal two carbon chain is CH3CH3. That would be if it was just by itself. It would just be a stick. Does that make sense? The name of that alkane, the red one right here, the name of that one, if it was just on its own, would be what? Alkane prefixes. It would be ethane. Does that make sense so far? But notice how the molecular formula is slightly different here. I have a 3, but when it's a substituent or a branch, it has a 2. So this is not, you can't just call it ethane. Instead, what we're going to do is we're going to represent it using a YL suffix. So basically, alkanes become alkyls. And I told you guys this already earlier when we were talking about functional groups, that if you have a chain coming off, you put a YL suffix for the alkane. Okay? So that means that this would be called ethyl, not ethane. Okay? The actual branch off right there. Okay, and that means that we're missing one hydrogen. Okay? So what I want you guys to do is we're going to put this all together. We're not going to name the entire thing yet, but we're pretty much going to get all the pieces. I want you guys to name the root chain, determine the direction of the root chain, and then identify and locate all the substituents. So we're going to do this as a worked practice, so we're going to do this together. But just go ahead and try to solve it on your own, and don't go to the next video until you're done with it.